On CPQ data management. All right, this one is, how do you enable and create promos? And how do you associate accounts with GPOs and pricing? Gilles, would you like to take this one first?
All right, so two very different areas here, two different questions. So for promos, the most common situation is that you will be able to use what we call a price roll to inject a specific discount, you know, like buy one, get one free. At the end of the day, it's a 50% discount. So those kind of rules can easily be supported by using price rolls. And the key thing here is that promotions are usually just limited in time. So you can use a Salesforce native platform artifact like a time-based workflow rule to enable and later disable the rule automatically based on when it starts and when it stops. In more complex kind of promos, especially if you use bundles, the easiest approach might be to just clone the normal bundle and modify it to take the elements of the promotion into account, and you enable that product, that bundle, during the same period of time using the same techniques.
But I did want to comment on the importance in the health industry of group purchasing organizations, and the types of contracts that flow through GPOs can represent significant amounts of volume and so forth. And there are complexities to working with those price lists, but Jules will simplify that in a moment. So Jules, why don't you give us the answer?
Sure. So yeah, GPO is very specific to healthcare and more specifically the medical device industry. We find it all over the place. Luckily, Salesforce CPQ is well equipped to address at least one version of the GPO pricing scenario. It's based on a concept in Salesforce CPQ called customer-specific pricing. By default, CPQ price engine, we look at customer-specific pricing associated with the account you're coding for, but you can use an indirection and tell the system to look at a different account. So the solution is, at the end of the day, fairly simple. You will create an account in Salesforce corresponding to the GPO and tell the price engine to look at the information from that GPO account when it comes to pricing. There are also some more complex scenarios where, because in the real world, the end customer might belong to multiple GPOs. And some companies have price policies where instead of picking from a single GPO, the requirement is to look at all the GPOs that this customer belongs to and return the lowest price among all the negotiated prices with the GPOs. So that model is not supported as is out of the box, but we can use lookup price rolls and even customization if needed to query the right kind of data. The key thing, again, referring back to another question before, it's all part of the master data. If that master data is somewhere in the system, is complete and accurate, we'll be able to put it for you.
Yeah, and I'd add that the importance of this is also bleeds over into the analytics, because reporting can be very simplified by using account hierarchies, as Jules described, to manage pricing and also therefore allow us to report, for instance, on a health system, but also dissect that health system and see what parts of it are purchasing through, for instance, a specific group purchasing organization, and account for that volume in two different dimensions.